Hey folks, here OS Reviews. You're watching our video first look and a quick review of the Alpha and Delta Jap. These are an all-new pair of TWS, or truly wireless earphones, that retails for $100, and you can find them on Amazon right now for a touch under 90. So these are pretty unique earphones for a number of reasons. First of all, the company Alpha and Delta, although it's not a really prominent name here in the States, they do produce pretty good audiophile quality in-ear style earphones and IEMs at an affordable cost. So they do produce quality audio products and accessories. The Jap is their first kind of Bluetooth wireless earphones that they've released in the market, and it tries to solve three problems. The first, traditional TWS earphones like the Apple AirPods have terrible battery life that can only last maybe upwards of 3 hours if you're lucky. Now the Jap can last for up to 6, 7, or even 8 hours on a single charge, and that's because the battery module is much larger. The second, most TWS earphones have bad audio quality because the reception just isn't very good. They're actually using better antennas integrated onto each of the ear tips. The third, which is that most TWS earphones are not very element proof. These are also sweat and water resistant, but more than that, they have what's called a spin fit silicone tip, which is a fully rotatable silicone tip that can fit more snugly into your ears and prevents them from falling loose when you're running or jogging outside. So there's been quite a lot of innovation put into this product that was first released on Indiegogo on Kickstarter a few months ago. So let's take a quick look at the packaging here. Very simple, not anything too fancy going on. On the back here, you can see that it's using Bluetooth version 4.1 to connect with any iOS, Android, or tablet, and it uses 11mm dynamic drivers. It's using Bluetooth version 4.2, has 11mm dynamic drivers, charges up in under 2 hours, and then gives you, again, pretty impressive battery performance. Inside the packaging, we have the earphones themselves. We'll take a closer look at the design in a moment. It doesn't come with a traditional charging kind of case, just because, again, these are a little larger with this extra battery pack, but it does have a kind of power bank that's integrated into the charging cable. It's very interesting. With this charging kind of cable, you can extend the battery performance up to 14 hours on a single go, which, again, is incredible. 14 hours is longer than even a traditional pair of Bluetooth earphones, so it really has battery life as one of its biggest highlights here for TWS. So, again, how you use this is basically you can, again, plug this into any micro USB based charger or power bank of its own. The charge to then plug into the USB ports on the left and right channels and to charge it that way, but then also offers the ability to, again, charge it when you're unplugged from power. In fact, there is a battery indicator here to tell you how much battery is left. So, very interesting accessory, and it's quite clever. This can actually be worn when you are wearing the earphones themselves. It dangles a little bit more, but you can dangle it in the front of your neck, almost like a necklace, and it still remains reasonably comfortable if you want to kind of charge it while you're listening to music. Now, as far as other accessories, you get quite a lot of tips. First of all, we have what's called these spin fit tips, which are, again, that very interesting rotatable silicone tips. So if we open the packaging and take a look at what makes them special, we can see that there is kind of a protruding edge in the center that is the part that's completely rotatable, and then the silicone tip itself can kind of rotate like this 360 degrees, so once it's in your ears, it prevents it from falling out as easily. It's quite an interesting kind of design. But in addition to these spin fit tips, we also have traditional or regular silicone tips for different sizes, and there are comply foam tips as well, so you can squeeze these shut and then they will slowly expand in your ears like memory foam to get the most secure seal. So these are probably the best for long-time listening. If you want comfort, if you want the best audio experience, this is probably best if you are doing rigorous exercising and movement, and these are good enough for casual listening. So there's three types of tips. There's a traditional micro USB cable for charging, and we have just the earphones. So really clever as far as the included accessories. Taking a look at the Jap's here from a design perspective, the first thing that you notice is that, again, these are slightly oversized for TWS earphones, and that's because of the element-proof nature and, of course, the larger battery pack. There's LED lights in the front that will illuminate to tell you when it's pairing as well as when it's being turned on. This part extends on the outside of your ears to provide some extra support, and then this goes onto the inside and catches onto the insides of your ears to prevent them from falling out. It does have a very striking and interesting look, especially with this circular kind of dot for the in-ear style earphones. On the side here, you have the flaps that covers up the micro USB ports for charging and for power. And otherwise, the center key here also dubs as the power switch. So I can tap on this for a few seconds to turn it on. And when it's flashing, it's entered the pairing mode. You can see it flashing red and blue. All you need to do is use the one of the earphones to pair with the phone, turn on the other one, and it's going to pair automatically or sync automatically with the pre-existing one. So you don't have to pair it two times. Otherwise, once it's paired, you can also tap on this to play pause your music, as well as skip tracks or answer and reject phone calls that are coming in. So very clever. The arm here is a little bit large, but overall it's not too uncomfortable just because it will catch on the side of your ears, which is kind of supporting the weight. Again, it's a little bit heavier and bulkier than an average pair of TWS earbuds, but at the same time, you do get, again, much, much longer battery life. When it comes to audio performance, the Japs sound very good. In fact, the bass is probably the most impressive thing. It's quite bass heavy, so if you're listening to drum beats, EDM music, then this will please you greatly. Also, if you're watching movies, thrillers, action, horror films, then this is actually going to bring that movie experience to life. Definitely one of the best in lower frequency reproduction for true wireless earphones that I've tested. And I've already gone through about 20 to 30 different pairs, so this actually sounds quite good. For mids and highs, it sounds clean. So if you're listening to speech, if you're listening to podcasts, as well as vocals and light instrumentals, it does a great job as well. The most impressive thing is how clean it sounds. Usually, true wireless earphones have a lot of static and distortion, especially at lower price points. That means if you're pausing the music, you're bound to hear a little bit of static or hissing in the background. With these, they sound almost completely silent. It's almost like using wired earphones. So the quality here is actually quite good, especially for the price and the fact that it's a first attempt by the company. So they've done a good job there. Now, it's not perfect yet. There's still a little bit of audio latency. Syncing is easy, but at the same time, sometimes the slave, which is the unit that connects to the master that connects to your phone first, tends to get disconnected when the battery is running out. Maybe once every 7 hours, when it's getting towards the end of its battery life, you may have it disconnect once or twice and then kind of have to repair it when you charge it for a few minutes. So it's not perfect, but overall it also works pretty well. Obviously, quality here is good, but it's not quite, hi-fi audiophile quality like their more traditional IEMs that the company has released in the past, since the emphasis here is still going to be on portability. Most Bluetooth earphones are not going to be top of the end sound quality. That's always going to be wired earphones. But for wireless, they already sound excellent. Again, battery life is the main selling point, and they did not disappoint me. I got indeed roughly 6 hours of continuous audio playback that sounded excellent, and volume was also quite comfortable. Using the built-in microphone, I could also answer calls, and there's a little bit of noise cancellation going on as well, since there's two mics. And that means if I'm outdoors, it does also cancel out the crowd and the background sounds, which makes it easier to hear for my callers, which is good. With the built-in kind of charging accessory here, you could indeed extend the battery life, although I found it to be a little bit uncomfortable in practice to also wear this around my neck from time to time. However, it's a cool accessory and indeed gets you, again, 14 hours of continuous audio playback, which is, again, pretty insane. They are fairly comfortable, and the most impressive thing is, at first, I thought it would be too heavy or impractical, but the weight is actually very minimal, just because your ears are really supporting kind of the battery pack here, which is also cleverly made out of a very lightweight plastic. So they tried to make this as light as possible, and as a result, After about 30 minutes of listening, I really forgot that they were there, which is good. The seal of the ear tips are also good, canceling out most of the background sound despite not being active noise canceling. But using the Comply foam tips that came included with it was the best experience. It was the most immersive and the most comfortable. Spin tips worked well when I was jogging outside. They never fell out of my ears at all. Although one thing I will say is that because this is kind of going on the back of your ears, if you do wear glasses with thick frames, that might interfere a little bit and it might get a little slippery. But overall, it's not a huge problem, and it was still quite comfortable in my testing. So I have to say that I'm impressed with the Jap True Wireless earphones. It does indeed solve the three problems that I outlined the company tried to solve from the very beginning. So I think Alpha and Delta did a great job for something of a first attempt. It's not perfect, but at the same time, battery life is excellent, and that really is a pain point for most consumers looking at TWS in the first place. Audio quality is also a lot better than I expected, and overall, I think this is a great True Wireless earphone to check out if you are looking for something that's going to last you for hours and hours, and also to take with you when you are running, jogging, or going to the gym. Thanks for watching this video here at OS Reviews. This has been the Alpha and Delta Jap True Wireless earphones.